However, some of the interesting and some of the non-linear kind of them I will like to discuss or at least show you. Many of these circuits are given in the books, particularly the Smith and Cedras book. So you need not have to really write down what I am saying, because these are actually taken from the book itself. Okay. However, there are tricks something which I might have added, but not much. One of the use of a op-amp is to convert what I should say V to I converter or I to V converter, and this is a typical current to voltage converter. You have a current source, and obviously we know in the op-amp, if it is in the negative feedback system and the V plus is grounded, the current entering here from the current source must enter through RF, because no current can enter op-amp. Why we say so? Because input impedance is treated very, very high, roughly infinite. Okay. In ideal case it is infinite. Since that moves through this, so one can write I2, which is 0 minus V0 by RF, is equal to I1, which is nothing but IS. So V0 is IS times RF, and therefore one can say output voltage is proportional to the input current. Okay. Therefore it is called voltage to current converter. Okay. If you put a resistor here, it will be a normal gain amplifier, which can be output multiplied by something more, can be actually voltage to voltage converters. Okay. Just to say you that why it is called voltage to current converters. This is very simple, most of us use it indirectly or directly, but there is something which is of an interest. Normally all amplifiers can be voltage to current converters, but here is something which is interesting. If you want voltage to current converter, one of the thing which you are expecting, please remember in this circuit it was I to V, but if you are doing V to I, the I will be decided by the load current, how much load you put. Larger the load currents will be proportional to that actually. But what is a good current source at the output? That current should be independent of the load. That is what we are looking. So here is this modified circuit of normal V to I. Any op-amp is a V to I converter. That is not a big issue. But here is something, a modified V to I converter, which shows that the output current is independent of the load. Here is my load circuit. Here is my normal op-amp. This is my R1, R2 feedback. Input is given here. Now what I am doing, from the output, I have a resistor which is connected to the load, and this is the current which I am interested in, IL. IL is my output current which I want to be proportional to Vin. Is that correct? What is my requirement? IL should be proportional to Vin and not functions of ZL itself. Okay. Is that point clear? What are we looking for? We do not want, if I change ZL, the IL should not change. In normal sense it will, and we do not want that to happen. So I did it, I took a feedback from this common point and return it to V plus and put a resistor down. Okay. This is a very simple interesting circuit. Please remember, this is a negative feedback and this is to some extent positive feedback going on. We are trying to adjust the net feedback now. Okay. We also know V minus is V plus. Okay. And not equal to 0, because this potential will not be 0 now. Okay, is that point? This V plus will not be 0 now. There is a divider going on. So obviously V plus is not, and that is equal to the potential VL. Is that point clear? This VL is same as this, and therefore V plus is actually V minus. So V minus is V plus equal to VL and not 0. Okay, as we normally assume, because there we always say V plus is grounded. In this case, V plus is not grounded. So we can say on how much is VL is essentially IL times ZL is the voltage drop across ZL. IL times ZL is VL. Okay. Now what I am trying to say, that is IL should be independent of ZL. That is what I am looking for. I also know current entering here must enter to the feedback. So I1 is I2, as no current enters op-amp. In what cases current can enter op-amp? If the RIs are not very high and the other resistances are small enough, some current may enter op amp proportionately. But our assumption as of now is we are close to ideal op amps, no current or practically zero current actually flows. Okay, this is an assumption. In real life there is a modification has to be done because it may not be very very accurate in most cases. But as I say, difference potentials will be order of less than a millivolt. So our assumption of V minus equal to V plus, which makes Ri close to infinity, is not very invalid assumptions. Okay. Please look at the circuit if you are drawn, keep watching that. All that I did is I am now trying to get the current equation V in minus VL. Please remember V minus is VL. So V in minus VL by R1 is VL minus V0 by R2, which is the current flowing from this. Is that correct? I1 and I2 are equal. So I1 is V in minus VL by R1 and I2 is VL minus V0 by R2. They are equal. But I know VL is IL RL. Right now ILZL. So V in minus ILZL by R1 is ILZL minus V0 by R2. This is one equation of interest. For example, the second equation, please note down, all that I am doing is substituting VL equal to ILZL. Is that correct? Substituting VL is ILZL in my earlier equations. Substitute VL by ILZL. Is that okay? No great thing, no great action going on, just simple substitutions. Now I am interested in the current entering from feedback side through a resistor R3, and that current I declare it as I3. Okay. So I say I3, how much is I3 will be from here in the figure? This potential minus this potential divided by R3. This potential minus this potential divided by R3, simple Ohm's law, nothing great. Okay. So I said I3 is V0 minus VL by R3, but I again resubstitute VL by V0 minus ILZL by R3. This may be my interest of second equation. But if you see at this point, at this node, what are the, this node and this node are same, is that correct? They are connected. So what is the, at this node, what is the Kirchhoff law will say at this node currents, current sum should be 0. So I said okay, I3 is IL plus I4, IL plus I4 is I3, okay. But how much is I4? VL by R4, but VL is IL ZL by R4. So I substitute again in this equation third, okay, which is V0 minus IL ZL by R3 is equal to IL plus I4, which is ILZL by R4. So if I do this and collect terms now, I am what is the interest I am looking? I am looking for load current in terms of Vin, and what I am expecting at the end, it should not be function of ZL. If I get it, I have achieved what I am starting with. Is that point clear? My ultimate aim is to get IL in terms of Vin. But the term should not have any ZL term, okay, because if that happens then the source is, output current is function of the load itself, which no one will like because I do not know what I am going to connect later. Okay, so I want a current output which is only function of input voltage. So if I do this, collect the terms as I did from these three equations, I am going to get IL into R2 by R1 upon ZL plus R3 minus 1 minus, I just collected IL terms equal to Vin upon R2 by R1S. Now what is the condition I should have that IL should not be a function of ZL? The upper equation shows there is ZL terms appearing, is that correct? ZL terms appearing. If I want IL to be only functions of resistances, okay, independent of ZL, what is the condition I should meet? That R2 by R1 R3, R2 upon R1 R3, what is the term I am talking which is functions of Z4? This term must be equal to, then these terms will cancel. Is that clear? If this R2 by R1 R3 is equal to 1 upon R4, these two terms will cancel, is that correct? So the condition that IL will not be a function of ZL will be R2 by R1 R3 is equal to 1 upon R4, and if I then substitute here, IL is 1 upon R4 into Vin. This R2 upon R1 R3 has been replaced by 1 upon R4 now. This R2 upon R1 R3 has been replaced by 1 upon R4. So we say IL is Vin by R4, is that correct? So we have now got the output current which is independent of ZL and only a proportional to input voltage. But under what condition this was derived? That R1, R2 upon R1 R3 must be equal to 1 upon R4. If this condition is met, the output current will be independent of any load value, which as long as this identity holds, this will always be valid. Is that correct? So choice of resistances can make output current proportional to Vin but independent of ZL. This is very simple circuit and has been used almost extensively everywhere when you want current source to the next stage proportional to the input voltage. In the op amp there is no real difference between them, okay. Is that clear? Yeah, that is what I say. In op amp there is no nothing much because the op amp allows all AC DC inputs, okay. So is that, so this is a slightly different circuit which is standard V2I is always known to us. Just put a op amp and it is V2I converters, okay. But here we found out that that term will be what the load goes may have a function of that. So we just wanted to find a condition in which output currents will be independent of the load itself. This is something slightly additional circuit which we added there to make the point clear. Is that clear? So these circuits are also given in books but maybe on sites, you can see some websites. But this is a standard circuit which is used extensively on the chip, okay. Therefore I thought I should show you that how do we actually get current sources for the next stage, okay. Is that correct? What should be it called? There is, this is a current source proportional to what? Voltage. So what is it should be called? CS? Voltage controlled current source. This is voltage controlled current source, VCCS. Is that point clear? The name is VCCS, voltage controlled current source. By similar logic we can create current controlled voltage sources, current controlled current sources, everything is possible by some small tricks here or there. Is that clear to you? These are the tricks which we will use whenever we need for the driving something what we need and what is available as an input we can convert correspondingly to the drive the next stage. Drive, you understand what is the word I keep using, drive? When I actually give that output of that stage to the input of the next, called driving, okay. I drive it, okay. Is that point clear? There is, of course, we are not talking any technology here. Not many good students in this. We have a process called diffusion in the case of making integrated circuits. When P type or N type impurities are introduced into the other kind of material, and the process is called diffusion. So first we put some impurities on the surface and then we call drive in, okay, impurities get in. The second two circuits I will not spend much time, but they are very important circuits in our analysis of many circuits. These are essentially why I am showing you this, because I am going to go for filters and I need these kind of circuits there. Op-amp can be utilized to create a differentiator as well as an integrator. Can you think, if I have a differentiator and I want to convert it to integrator, what should be the, without thinking much, integration is opposite that of differentiation. C dV by dt is I, so V is in 1 upon C integral I dt. This fact that I just have to do opposite of that makes integrator convert to differentiator and differentiator going to integrator. So we will see both of them quickly if do not mind. This is my a capacitor in the series of the input through a feedback resistor R. The current entering capacitor is C dV by dt. Now that DC cannot go, madam, once I put a series capacitance I am only talking of time dependent terms. So C dV in by dt is the current through capacitor must pass through R, which is 0 minus V0 by R, and if I therefore write V0, then V0 is minus RC dVin by dt. Is that correct? Please look at what is the current in R, 0 minus V0 by R, that is equal to C dVin by dt, essentially saying V0t is minus RC dVin by dt. So what I am saying, output is proportional to differential of input. Is that correct? This is differentiator. If you look at from the transfer function side, put it 1 upon Cs here, do all the analysis, get a transfer function V0 by Vns, which is omega Cr. And if I plot this as the gain function, there is a 0 going here at 1 upon Rc, and it will give 20 dB per decade rise. Is that correct? So what, why I showed you, if there is a capacitor here at the input, at that 0 point the gain will start 20 dB per decade. This is something you should remember. So wherever there is a capacitor or a differentiator circuit, it is essential in a transfer function Bode plot saying at that 0 the gain will, or transfer function magnitude will start rising by how much? 20 degree per decade. Can you convert it to octave also? What is it equivalent will be? They keep writing many books, 6 dB per octave. Calculate karke dekho, to the base 10, to the base 8, kya farak hai? Convert it to logarithmic, simple, okay, from going to one, this to the other. So is that point clear? What is the point I am saying? This is what we wanted. But this essentially what I am trying to show, that whenever I see a capacitor there in a transfer function of this kind, I am as if trying to rise my magnitude by 20 dB per decade after 1 upon RC value. Okay. This fact I am going to utilize in my filter design. Is that word clear to you? Why I am showing you this? Because ultimately my aim is not to use differentiator integrator just for the heck of it. I am going to use them as, can you think about what is, let us say per se after somewhere this occurs like this. So what kind of filter I am looking for? High pass. So abhi samajh mein aa gaya ki aisa kahin capacitor hai to isse high pass banaya ja sakega. Is that point clear? If I somehow make ahead of this something like this, so below that nothing is passing, beyond that everything will pass. तो एक कैपेसिटर सीरीज में डालते वक्त आपको दिमाग में आना चाहिए कि हम क्या करने जा रहे हैं, व्हाट आई एम गोइंग टू डू नाउ इफ आई पुट अ सीरीज कैपेसिटर. दिस इज व्हाट यू शुड अंडरस्टैंड इन प्रिंसिपल. सर्किट इज नॉट वेरी ग्रेट बिकॉज देयर इज नथिंग वेरी ग्रेट हैपनिंग इन ए सर्किट, बट व्हाट इज प्रिंसिपल बिहाइंड इज दिस. ओ इफ आई डू दिस, ओ देन आई एम अलाउिंग अदर फ्रीक्वेंसीज. ओके, व्हाट विल आई नीड अदरवाइज? आई विल ऑल्सो नीड लो पास. ओके, आई ऑल्सो विल नीड लो पास. सो व्हाट इज अ लो पास विल बी? Initially it will pass everything, at certain point of frequency it should not pass ahead anything. So if I want to invert this, I should see integrator may be doing the same thing. Okay, integrate, because opposite of this will be a low pass and opposite of differential will be a integrator. So an integrator essentially will help you to get a low pass system. A series capacitance will give you, differentiator will give you, like to give you some kind of high pass applications. Can you now mix the two? What can you get then? I can get both band pass as well as band reject. Why? Because then I, right now I put both frequency like this. If I do this, then I can reject as well. So a general principle of filter is essentially taken from a simple transfer function which is essentially capacitor related. Is that point why we were all the time worried about that, where the poles are, where the poles are? Because at the end many applications will require some frequencies to pass and some frequencies be stopped. Okay, this is where the filters are most important in all applications. Okay, okay. So without going into much detail for integrator, if you see an integrator, I have an input, a resistor. So what do I do in integrator? Exchange capacitor with a resistor. Wherever there was a resistor, put a capacitor, wherever capacitor, put a resistor, and it will become inverse. Okay, V in by R is minus C dV0 by dt. So V0, okay, only thing you should remember, in the case of integrator, this initial value has to be specified because capacitor may come pre-charged. In most cases, if I want VCO to be 0, what should I do? Let us say initial, because once you do it, it will get charged. Okay. Now for the next application, I want VC to be 0 again. What should I do? Iske against kuch to bhi ek resistor dalke ek circuit lagana jo path dega jo usko discharge karne ko allow kare input. Is that correct? So we will see that whenever we want to discharge a capacitor, a parallel path must be provided through a resistance which is switched. Why it is called switched one there? Because when during the process of integration, I do not want that switch to be open. This switch to be open when I am doing like this. But when I do not want to do this, I want to discharge the charge put on the capacitor through our resistor. Is that correct? This is something we do always in all integrators. Is that clear? The charge, otherwise what will happen, the next time it will pile on that. Okay, is that correct? So if I want this term to go 0 every next time, then I must actually discharge the capacitor before the next integration is going to be. Is that correct? So there is some resistor with a switch is always connected across the capacitor to remove the charge from that. Is that correct? This is a technique which is universal in all analog, digital or whatever you say. This is the standard technique of removal of charge, pre-charge system. Okay. Iska ye kya hoga? Transfer function 1 upon SCR hai. So there is a pole, this will go up to from here to here, 20 dB per decade, and this is essentially saying if initially it was constant and at this point this will give me a low pass. I can adjust these two values where from it should start. Okay. So I can say I can create a low pass putting an integrator, I can create a high pass using a differentiator. We will come to filters more detail, but this is just a basic principle behind filters. Okay. Before we go to filters, here is another interesting circuit. You have already done halfway rectifiers in your first year course. What is the way we rectify anything? Normally, if you have a diode, okay, load here and a signal here. What is the way, say this is a halfway rectifier we say. So whenever this becomes positive signal, the diode conducts. Okay, diode conducts, so all of it is transferred to RL. Okay, whenever this becomes negative, diode is switched, reverse biased, and no output is seen. Is that correct? So we say rectified, AC became DC. One directional, unidirectional. Now the problem with any diode will require at least 0.65 or 0.6 or called gamma as we say voltage drop for turning it on. Okay, cut-in voltage is roughly 0.6 to 0.65, typically 0.65. So at least till that happens the device will not turn on. Is that clear? Now this fact means but I want, that means for certain values you cannot actually switch it on. Ye yahan zero nahi hai, yahan par aake hi wo turn on hoga. Thoda voltage jaane ke baad hi it will start. So in fact the yahan se start nahi hoga, aage se jaake start hoga. Is that clear? This is a weakness of this. So I want to make a more precision. I say as close to zero can I get it, or maybe few microvolts, 50 microvolts instead of 600 millivolts. I want 50 microvolts. Jahan par wo switch ho jaye. This will be therefore called what? Precision rectifiers. Is that correct? Why precision? I want this switchover be occurring at close to 0 or at least in microvolts, okay, not in millivolts. This is what we are looking for, and therefore this circuit is essentially called a rectifier. As I say, I will not dwell too much in detail, I just to the principle behind. These circuits are given in books, so it is not anything great I am talking, I am only trying to explain what is the basic system we are working at. Okay. There is a diode in series to the output of a op-amp, which is, what is this connection will be called? Follower. So we are using a follower out in between the load and there is a diode, and we expect V0 will be then. switching on off at very close to 0 or as close to 0 as is possible. Now think of it, diode has a voltage drop of 0.6 volt okay, for cut-in. What is the typical gain of an op-amp, I mean this diffamp or op-amp? 10 to power 4 or 10 to power 5. So if I see input, if output is 0.6 volt, what will be input? V minus V plus is my Vd. How much will be it that? 0.6 divided by 10 to power 5. How much is this? This is 60 microvolt. Okay. So in 60 microvolt difference, the diode will conduct. Is that correct or not conduct? 60 microvolt. Okay, 6. Now it depends on the gain I use. Okay, you are right. So is that point clear? That very small change in V in differential, I can make output go high or low, I mean act as a rectifier, because diode will be switched off at less than 0.6. Is that correct? Anything less than that it will switch off. In earlier case it could not, because it is a 0.6 voltage drop was required to on and off the switch. Okay. This fact that I can now switch off or switch on even at a very low differential is something very great, because then the output will be immediately 0 going to cut off or going to full signal passing by just small change. Is that correct? So is that what precision is clear to you? Why I call precision? Because small change at the input can rectify now, because the gain is very high. The diode drop of 0.6 is equivalent to in 6 microvolt at the input, which means small change here will actually create 600 millivolt at the output, which will turn it on or turn it off. This is why we say it is precision rectifier. So the theory behind is a diode current is ISQVF by NKT, eta KT. How much is eta in silicon devices? If I plot IV, aisa kuch characteristics hai actually diode. Yes, so not 0, sorry, ye 0.6 hai. Okay. Pahle yahan initial slope kitna rehta hai? E to the power QV by how much? Eta kitna hota hai? 2 KT hota hai. Beech mein QV by KT hota hai. Aur yahan aate aate QV by 2 KT hota hai. Physics kya hai iska? ये सिलिकॉन जर्मेनियम से रिलेटेड नहीं है, ये प्रिंसिपल ऑफ डिवाइस ही है. डिफ्यूजन क्या है, जनरेशन रिकॉम्बिनेशन क्या है, कौन सा करंट कब डोमिनेट करता है, उसका प्रोपोर्शनलिटी है ये. तो इसलिए आई जस्ट टोल्ड यू दैट समवे बिफोर यू गो लुक एट इट, द नॉर्मल स्लोप स्टार्ट्स विद 2 केटी, 1/2 KT, देन बिकम्स 1/KT काइंड, देन अगेन बिकम 2 KT काइंड. व्हिच टर्म्स स्टार्ट डोमिनेटिंग इन द करंट्स, ओके, व्हिच फिनोमेना, therefore it is proportional to different way. Okay, this is just to show you why it is precision. The word was people, there is, they have not explained in some books. Okay, so I thought at least you should know why these are called precision rectifier. Usme precision kya hai, ek diode lagaya, yahan bhi diode hai, to precision kahan se hai? Precision amplifier jo lagaya hai usse aa raha hai, op amp se aa raha hai. This fact you must understand, op amp is doing great business for you indirectly. It's not actually participating, because current to bahar bhi aa rahe the, nikal rahe hain, par ye itne se karan wo game khel gaya. That is why it should be important. Okay, yadi aap kisi cheez ka logarithm nikalna chahte hain. Acha, ek computers aap logon ne kabhi padha hai ke naam? There used to be initially when we started education in your time 30-40 years ago, we used to have a those digital computers haven't come. Okay, we only knew some, you know, when we say logic and gate bataya to hum expert mane jate the. There were other kinds of computing systems, which were there, those analog computers. We have worked on that, analog computers. Okay, so analog computers mein sirf differential integrator hi lagte hain, but we could do lot of games using analog computing. Usme kabhi kabhi aisa demand hua ki logarithm nikalna hai, to kaun sa circuit us samay use hua tha? ये वो है, इट इज नॉर्मल सर्किट. इंस्टेड ऑफ ए रजिस्टर हियर I put a diode here, is that correct? I put a diode here. What is the input current? V in by R, is that correct? But that same current must go through this, which is the I2, which must be the diode current, because please remember diode does not listen anything, it only passes as per its diode theory. I just calculated ID current in the rectifier. ID, I have, did you see that current ID? Is e to the power qf by kt is the ID current, is that diode current. Now please check it, if ID is 0, how much is V0? 0, no connection. That means if ID is 0, that means there must not be any current here. Why there should not be current here? Because no current can enter op-amp. If there is no current here, there cannot be current here. If initially there is no capacitor, output is 0 if there is no current passing through this, okay. So if ID becomes this, that means you can say last voltage, but if capacitor, it will be finally discharged through internal op-amp, okay. So if this is 0, V in has to be 0, then there is no current here. But if diode conducts, what does that mean? This potential must be larger than V0. यहाँ का पोटेंशियल इससे ज़्यादा होना चाहिए, निगेटिव होना चाहिए, इससे जीरो है तो ये माइनस होना चाहिए, ज़्यादा होना चाहिए, कितना ज़्यादा होना चाहिए? एटलीस्ट 0.65 होना चाहिए, तभी वो डायोड कंड, ये पोटेंशियल हायर नहीं होगा इससे, डायोड कैन नॉट कंडक्ट, इज दैट करेक्ट? इफ दैट इज सो, वन कैन से इफ द दिस इज ए वोल्टेज ड्रॉप वी एफ, वी एफ प्लस वी जीरो मस्ट बी जीरो बिकॉज दिस इज जीरो, इज दैट करेक्ट? विच मीन्स V0 is minus Vf, and Vf कितना निकाला अभी देखा क्या expression निकाला था ना मैंने, ये Vf का eta kt by q log I minus log Is, ये Vf है, ये मैंने यहाँ लिख दिया. So V0 is eta kt by q log Vin minus log R minus log Is, or to say minus eta kt by q log Vin by I Is. So V0 is proportional to logarithm of Vin. With a constant, okay, this is the constant part, okay. So this is essentially called logarithmic amplifier. If this is 0, no current, if there is no current, that is diode is switched off, no current can enter here either, okay. However, if the current has to pass, this potential has to be 0.65, or this should be at least higher than this. That means this potential plus this potential must be this, this plus this, sum of the two, that is V0 plus Vf must be 0 because this potential is 0 at this node, is that correct? Which means V0 must be minus Vf when the diode conducts, correct. When it is not conducting, this potential has to be smaller than that, only then it is not conducting. Essentially if it is not conducting, there is no potential here. If there is no potential, there should not be any current coming from here. So there is no 0.65 drop it can create. So diode is switched off. Okay, rectify kiya na usko. Irrespective, the expression which I got, whenever diode will conduct, it will do logarithmic situation. It has to conduct. Is that correct? Cut in nahi hua to Vf hai na, hi cut in hai na. Which is essentially given in terms of the values given to me, but it is 0.65 anyway. Isse jyada hona chahiye. Is that clear? Then only it will conduct. Okay. So we say, acha ek anti-log amplifier ke liye kya karna chahiye? Ya exponential, anti-log is say exponential. Kya karna chahiye? Jo resistor hai, wahan diode lagaiye, aur jahan diode hai wahan ek resistor lagaiye. So it will become a anti-log amplifiers, exponential. मैं आपको करके नहीं दिखाऊंगा, सिर्फ सर्किट दिखा देता हूँ. सो इज इट क्लियर टू यू दैट इज समथिंग मिरर इज गोइंग ऑन, मिरर इज स्लाइटली डिफरेंट फ्रॉम कॉपी, ओके, उसका उल्टा दिखता है उसके ऊपर. इनको एक्सचेंज किया तो लॉग का एंटीलॉग हो जाता है और एंटीलॉग का लॉग हो जाता है. दिस इज़ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग एनालॉग सर्किट, इसीलिए बहुत इंटरेस्टिंग है, चरासा इधर से उधर, फंक्शन अलग. There is nothing great. I am just repeating op-amp basic theory. Current enters here, goes through here. If the diode is conducting, this will happen. If not conducting, it will be anyway switched off. So yahan par maine nikala hai V0 is minus IR exponential QVF by KT. So V0 is proportional to QVF by K. This essentially exponential of the drop, VF is a function of all I whatever you are looking, okay. So ye isko kya bolte hain, exponential or anti-log amplifiers. So you have a log amplifiers, you have anti-log amplifiers, you have a precision this. I will ask you now, you try, maybe you look into book. There are few more circuits in analog you did in your second year or maybe doing now. There is something called clamp, there is something called limiter, we use diodes there. A precision clamp and precision limiter, kaise banayenge isse se? I repeat, you try yourself. Two circuits, all these circuits kahan se liya hai maine, jo normal diode se hum bana sakte hain, wahi yahan karke dikhaya ja raha hai. OPAM ke sath better hai ye. I want to now create a precision clamp. What do you mean the precision clamp? Ek exact value par wo voltage wahan se badhna nahi chahiye, okay. Aur precision limiter maine current should not exceed beyond a given value at any cost, okay. Precision hona chahiye iska. So do circuit hain jo ki diode ke sath pehle humne design kiye hue hain, unko OPAM ke sath design kare and see that they are better than the without OPAM circuits. जैसे रेक्टिफायर दिखाया वैसा वो दो भी हैं. रेक्टिफायर दिखाया उसके जैसे ही एक क्लैम्प्स और लिमिटर्स भी आएंगे, उनका भी प्रॉपर्टीज यूजिंग ओपैम्स विल बी बेटर देन विदाउट यूजिंग ओपैम्स. एक्चुअली डू यू अंडरस्टैंड दिस सिंपल लॉजिक? एक देखो, एक्चुअली ओपैम डज नथिंग, ऑल दैट वी आर डूइंग इज ओनली दिस सर्किट. इज दैट क्लियर? सो व्हाई ओपैम देन? Because otherwise it is not this virtual ground nahi create hota hai, samjhe? Physically ground kiya to divider ho jayega, wo fir virtual ground nahi rahega, wahan current andar chala jayega fir, aur yahan current nahi ja raha hai. Ye jo facility aap create kar rahe hain, that is essentially because of an opam. Is that correct? So opam property directly is not appearing in anywhere here. Do you see anywhere opam ka gm nahi aa raha hai, av nahi aa raha, kuch bhi nahi aa raha hai, bhi nahi, kuch bhi nahi le rahe hum log. But we remove OPAM and everything will be lost. Is that clear? So please do not feel that OPAM does not play any role. OPAM actually is playing all the role indirectly, okay. And that is what you have utilized those properties, okay. So ye ek sawal hamesha pucha jata hai, maine jaise kiya ki yaar itna hai to isko hata lo na, fir nothing is happening in the triangle anyway. Achha, ek baat hai, now that you have, this is a very trivial query. एक ओपैम है, यहां से इनपुट आ रहा है, ये करंट आए यहां से शुरू हुआ, यहां से आई टू, आई टू गया किधर? नॉर्मली क्या होता है कि एक सर वो लोड रहता है यहां तो ग्राउंड होता है, अभी तो लोड भी नहीं रखा है मैंने, तो करंट गया किधर? द आउट थ्रू एन ओपैम द आउटपुट स्टेज एक्चुअली सिंक्स इट. इज दैट करेक्ट? सो द करंट पाथ is like this. Is that clear? So this fact has to be understood that OPAM looks as if it is open circuited, but it is not, it is essentially providing a path internally. Is that clear? These are trivials, but this makes OPAM theory much more interesting, that how OPAM is doing all its mischiefs, okay. Ek aur final circuit hai analog ka jo ki bahut interesting bhi hai, okay. So there is an amplification, sorry, there is a multiplier which can be analog. What do you want to multiply? I want to multiply two voltages V1 and V2, okay. So I say, okay, I go back to my simple maths. I say log of AB is log A plus log B. Log of AB, so AB is my product. So isko kaise likh sakte hai is equation ko? AB is, which is a product of A and B, is anti-log of log A plus log B. Is that correct? Anti-log of log A plus log B. Kitne circuits hum main use karne se multiply kar sakta hun, jo list maine diya. I should create one logarithmic amplifier to create log A. Similarly, I should create logarithmic amplifier for B, so log B. then I must create sum of the two, because log a plus log b chahiye to ek summer chahiye mere ko. Aur chautha ya teesra circuit kya hona chahiye, ye 1 2 sum aur anti log. To yadi main aise char block banau to main a b jaisa multiplier I can create. I create log a, I create log b, I sum them by summer and then I take anti log of that. Okay, so I get AB as multiplication. Ye theory hai analog multipliers, is that clear? So given two voltages to multiply, first create logarithmic of first voltage, logarithmic of second voltage, then add them. How do you sum them? Summer is the easiest circuit which you already done. Ek hi input par dono do through input lagao resistor ke through, then you sum them, and once you get sum them, put an anti log amplifier to create the multiplier. This is my V1. The first block is giving me log V1. This is log V1. This is log V2. What is this? Summer. Two input. एक V1 का input लिया, एक log V2 का input लिया. इसको sum किया. एक anti log amplifier लगाया. Anti log system बनाया. V1. Is that point clear? So if you are given a function, now you can understand how we were doing in analog computations of arithmetics. You can see how we were doing it. We were trying to use op-amps everywhere to create arithmetic, is that correct? Arithmetic. They were constant one kiya ja sakta hai. Sorry, haan, yahan par ek resistor batana bhul gaya main. Constants ko to hamesha one kiya ja sakta hai. By choice of values, is that okay? Char block, do log banane ka, ek sum karne ka aur ek anti log karne ka, to product aa gaya aapke paas. Isse bhi ek acha multiplier analog ka hai, wo simple hai, ek op amp se kiya ja sakta hai. Four quadrant multiplier bolte hain, plus minus multiplication ho sakta hai. Okay, since we are looking for ultimately what is the importance of my op-amp for what I am looking for, I am looking for what we call, there is a word in electrical engineering, you are also doing a course in that name, it's called signal processing, is that correct? The word is signal processing. What does signal processing means? There is an input signal on which you do some mischief and get some output signal. Okay, now what mischief we do is a different game. कुछ ट्रांसफॉर्म्स निकाल सकते हैं, कुछ टाइम टू फ्रीक्वेंसी कन्वर्ट कर सकते हैं, सब कुछ किया जा सकता है, बट देर इज समथिंग प्रोसेसिंग इज डन. वन ऑफ द सिग्नल प्रोसेसिंग रिक्वायरमेंट इज फिल्टरिंग. दैट मीन्स सर्टन पार्ट ऑफ द सिग्नल आई वॉन्ट टू पास एंड सर्टन आई डोंट वॉन्ट, इज दैट करेक्ट? सो दिस इज फर्स्ट सिग्नल कंडीशनिंग जिसको बोलते हैं, उसमें वन ऑफ द मेजर कॉम्पोनेंट ऑफ सिग्नल कंडीशनिंग इज filter, is that correct? Now if you want to learn filters, you must know bit little bit of Bode plots, because only then you know how the filters can be created. Okay, what else you will require in signal conditioning other than filters? Jo aapko last part hai apna uska course ka, full analog kiya abhi tak. In world is, as you have learned by now, world is digital. Like or not like, 90% of the chips you use or the systems you use are digital, but all nature signals are always analog. Okay, so what do we do? So we must convert our analog signal into digital. That is also another signal conditioning or signal processing. I am convert an analog signal into a digital signal, and for some reason I want to display. Like ghadi ka kaisa hai, tick tick tick, I want to display that. Like in computer also, if you see many laptops or this, they show a watch which is like running analog actually. So they must be having a digital to analog converters, is that correct? So the last part of this course will be analog to digital converters and digital to analog converters. Okay, which ones will be maximum used? A to D, because you need not require every time display which is analog. Okay, you need only this. So all the processing, first thing is there are many other processing part, but at least the two of them which are most crucial for us, one is filtering, the other is A to D converters. So we were looking for frequency response, which is essentially for any amplifier or any system is interesting. If you have an op-amp which is an open loop case, then the open loop gain is A0 upon 1 plus j by omega 0. This is a transfer function for a normal open loop amplifier, okay, op-amp. Ek pole hai omega 0 par, gain is falling 20 log V2 by V1 after omega 0, and at 0 the gain is DC gain, which is A0. This is a transfer function of open loop op-amp, and therefore omega 0 is the dominant pole. Ya aage pole honge to aur bhi aa sakta hai, but assuming there is a dominant pole far away from others, what does that mean? What is the what it will satisfy automatically? If I have a dominant poles far away from other poles and zeros, what does that actually guarantee me? Yadi ye pole आने वाले पोल आगे हैं तो क्या मतलब है उसका, व्हाट विल बी द फेज मार्जिन देन? पॉजिटिव, सिस्टम विल बी स्टेबल इनाफ, इज दैट करेक्ट? सिस्टम विल बी स्टेबल इनाफ, ओके. सो राइट नाउ अजम्पशन इज देयर इज अ डोमिनेंट पोल अवे फ्रॉम अदर पोल, सो ओनली वी आर लुकिंग फॉर द फर्स्ट पोल, ओके. ओके, एट प्लीज रिमेंबर, दिस इज एन इंटरेस्टिंग फैक्ट यू कैन सी. ओमेगा 0 टू ओमेगा टी जाने में A0 टू 10 पे आना चाहिए आपको. क्यों ऐसा थ्योरी क्यों हो रहा है ऐसा? बिकॉज एवरी डिकेड यू मूव ऑन द फ्रीक्वेंसी, हाउ मच डीबी इट गोज? 20 dB और 20 log A0 एसेंशियली इज व्हाट यू आर गोइंग डाउन, इज दैट करेक्ट? सो यदि इसका जो रेशो होगा ओमेगा टी दिस, या ट्रायंगल के हिसाब से देखा तो वो A0 ही होना चाहिए, इज दैट करेक्ट? Let's say 10 times, this is 10 times, is that correct? 20 log per decade. So, here 20 dB hai, to yeh 0 pe aayi jaye. Is that clear? So, what does it trying to tell you? It says that if you have a dominant pole approximation valid, system is stable, omega 0 into A0 is the unity gain frequency, which is essentially saying, because unity gain means yahan bhi A hai, but wo kitna hai? Unity hai. Gain bandwidth is constant. Please look at it what I said. Yahan par ye A0 omega 0 gain bandwidth hai. Is that clear? Aage yahan par kitna gain? 1 into isse gain bandwidth product is constant for any amplifier. So omega 0 is the bandwidth, gain is A0 which is constant. No, bandwidth is the point at which the gain starts falling, that is the first pole is the bandwidth, is that correct? So A0 into omega 0 is the gain bandwidth product, is constant, even here it should be constant. So here if omega t is this, the unity gain must be achieved. What is this frequency? Gain bandwidth constant means product of gain into frequency at that point must be same everywhere. Gain fall hoga, tabhi frequency badhta hai. Yahan par what is omega t? How do I define this? A is 1. So what is the multiplier? 1 into omega t is gain into frequency. But that means this frequency into 1 must be same as anywhere which wherever you go. That is how omega t was derived, in fact. If you see Gm by C was derived on that principle. Please go back and read what we said. Please read it. This equation is always valid. If dominant pole approximation is valid, omega times is 10 ka karke dekho na, aapko maine abhi example bhi bulaya na, kitna bhi frequency ratio karo wo aata hai ki nahi dekho na tum. Gain usi hisab se fall hoga na. सिंगल पोल है ये ध्यान रखो, डबल पोल है तो वो वैलिड नहीं होगा, इसीलिए पहले बोला इट्स अ डोमिनेंट पोल अप्रॉक्सिमेशन. ओके, दिस रिलेशन इज वैलिड फॉर डोमिनेंट पोल अप्रॉक्सिमेशन. इफ दैट इज सो, देन ओमेगा टी इज यूनिटी गेन बैंडविड्थ और गेन बैंडविड्थ प्रोडक्ट जीबीडब्ल्यू. एजम्पशंस, other poles occur at much higher than omega greater than omega t and system is stable. This is my assumption which I have started with. Okay. Yeh hua open loop. Now let us say I have an amplifier which has a closed loop system with a feedback of R2 and series of R1, input is at R1. Input at which is this kind? Non-inverting kind. Same thing can be done for inverting, do not worry too much about that. Iska closed loop amplifier ka gain kaisa hoga? By feedback theory. This is which kind of feedback is this? Output V0 hai, uska part feed ho raha hai udhar. V0 ko 0 kiya to kya hoga? No feedback. So voltage is in shunt to that, that means the shunt feedback. Connect kahan par ho raha hai wo? Ek node par. So wahan kya connect ho? Wahan bhi shunt hai, current hai. So ye kaun sa amplifier hai? Shunt amplifier, is that clear? Shunt amplifier, is that correct? Okay, so maine aapko us din bola tha ki you actually use an op amp, this non-inverting kind or inverting kind, and see that shunt amplifier jo humne normally derive kiya and use feedback and verify whether our theory what we said is valid. Okay, ye main abhi assumption karke chal raha hu, aap verify karo. Okay, so the closed loop gain for this shunt amplifier is AOL upon 1 plus beta times AOL. So if I get feedback factor beta, if I derive open loop gain AOL, then I can get closed loop gain, which is how much is closed loop gain for this? 1 plus R2 by R1. So I must get using this as well, 1 upon R2 by R1, and which is that value will be? That will be a DC gain, but I am not interested only now in DC gain, I am interested in frequency dependence. Is that clear? Here AOL is not A0, it is AOL which is a frequency dependent terms. So now I use this theory. From the figure I see the feedback factor is given by R1 upon R1 plus R2 or something like this. Now I write closed loop frequency dependent gain is AOL upon 1 plus AOL times beta. I collect the terms. Normally this AO is only AOL, huh? Open loop hai ye. Ye zero, A0 zero jo hai sab open loop hai. Is that term correct to me? AO is much greater than 1 plus R2 by R1. Is the term open loop gain of an op amp is very large compared to 1 plus R2 by R1? How much is AOL, AO open loop will be? 10 to power 4 or 10 to power 5. So our assumption at, if that is so, I can reduce some terms out of that. If this is valid, I will get closed loop gain at DC value is A0 upon 10 A2 upon this, which is roughly equal to 1 plus R2. So is that point clear? ACL0 is 1 plus R2 by R1. This is the value you got it. Under what condition you got this? Open loop gain is much larger. In deriving that op amp normal characteristics also, we kept saying that the AOL is very large, AOL is very large, so only the current goes through input to the feedback network. This is the condition which we are satisfying there. Please look at it. What did I say? I substitute ye jo term hai, A0 upon 1 plus A0 upon 1 plus R2 by R1. If A0 open loop gain of an op amp is very very large, DC open loop gain is very very large, this term A0 upon this can be approximated by 1 plus R2 by, ye isko idhar le jao, isko upar le jao, so ye term aa jayega. Is that clear? Divide by A0, so 1 by A0 is 0. Okay, so is that clear? The closed loop DC gain jab humne nikala ya zero frequency gain nikala, to humne ye term nikali thi, 1 plus R2 by R1 nikala tha na. Under what conditions we have actually got it? A0 is much larger than this value, is that correct? So is now I am clear that using a feedback, when I make the same assumption again, I get the same gain values which I have got it. So is that now clear that the feedback amplifier theory is more universal and the normal solutions which we get, we assume that automatically and solve for it, because we say op-amp is ideal, input resistance is higher, gains are very high. This assumption is actually coming from these expressions. Is that correct? That A0 is much larger, therefore this is the value which you will get. Is that clear? That is why I say that any time you do feedback, it is much more general case. You do whatever otherwise is a specific case. Okay? So this example which I want to show you is how do I got that time by assumption is now provable that my assumption is this, which I can still get the same value. Okay? Now if I substitute this back into my closed loop this, then this is equal to 1 ACL 0 upon 1 plus j omega upon this. Okay. So what is the new bandwidth now? वो अभी सब्सटीट्यूट किया, ये 1 प्लस आर टू आर वन ये इसमें रखा तो ये टर्म आया मेरे पास, इसकी बैंडविड्थ क्या हुई, ए ओमेगा नॉट इंटू ए जीरो बाय ए सी एल जीरो, इसका नया बैंडविड्थ टर्म आ गया आपको. ओके, नया डोमिनेंट पोल आया आपके पास. इज दैट करेक्ट? लेट अस सी व्हाट वी हैव डन. इफ यू हैव ए ओपन लूप, दिस वॉज योर एम्पलीफायर Bode plot. Is that correct? If I have a closed loop, the ACL 0 is the DC gain, okay, and it has a pole of omega CL 0 which is here, omega 0 times A 0 by ACL 0 which is this quantity, aur yahan pole shuru ho gaya. However, according to me, I say onwards it will still follow the same path to omega. Is that point clear what I said? I could have said ऐसा भी हो सकता है या ऐसा भी हो सकता है, ऐसा भी सोच सकता था मैं, isn't it? But I say no, from beyond this value it will always follow the same path. What does that mean? The closed loop gain ka omega t should be same as omega t of open loop. Is that point clear? What is the proof I have to do? If it follows like this, means omega t of closed loop must be omega t of open loop, then only it will follow the same path from the same point. So now we will prove that both omegas are actually equal. Is that correct? If they are equal, abhi aapko samajh mein aa gaya ki ye feedback karne se kya advantage mila, bandwidth improve kar diya maine, but the gain kitna kiya, A0 से कितना आ गया, ए सी एल जीरो पे जो कि उससे छोटा है, गेन छोटा कर दिया. इज दैट करेक्ट? एट द कॉस्ट व्हाट, आई इम्प्रूव्ड माय बैंडविड्थ फ्रॉम ओमेगा जीरो टू ओमेगा सी एल जीरो एंड यूनिटी गेन बैंडविड्थ रिमेन्स सेम. नाउ वी मस्ट प्रूव दैट यूनिटी गेन बैंडविड्थ ऑफ ए क्लोज लूप सिस्टम इज सेम एज यूनिटी गेन बैंडविड्थ प्रोडक्ट फॉर यूनिटी बैंडविड्थ प्रोडक्ट फॉर क्लोज लूप. इफ यू प्रूव इट, my all assumptions that all that happens, upar ka curve flat hoke niche aata hai aur bandwidth badh jata hai. Can you think now if something else this can also occur? Yadi itna niche aaya to bandwidth itna ho jata. So you can go anywhere and you find if I reduce my gain, I will improve my bandwidth. Is that point clear? If I improve my decrease my gain, I will improve my bandwidth, or vice versa. If I reduce my bandwidth, I can improve my gains. In what case we said gain can still be boosted without loss of this cascode? What is the penalty we paid there? Additional power we have to give because all transistors must get saturation. VDS सबको देना पड़ेगा, saturate करना. पावर सप्लाई बढ़ाएंगे, पावर सप्लाई बढ़ाया, करंट सिंक होके आएगा तो पावर डिसिपेट कर, कॉस्ट दिया, बट व्हाट इज द एडवांटेज वी गॉट, वी ब्रोक दिस लाइन. ओके ओके ओके, सो आई हैव डन दिस प्रूफ दैट ओमेगा टी इज सेम फॉर बोथ ओपन एंड क्लोज लूप. एसीएल एट ओमेगा, लेट्स से ओमेगा टी डैश इज फॉर क्लोज लूप एंड ओमेगा टी इज फॉर द ओपन लूप. सो एसीएल एट ओमेगा इको ओमेगा टी इज हाउ मच, यूनिटी, isn't it? Unity gain है ना, तो unity. ACL 0 upon omega t dash upon omega 0 to this ये जो लास्ट का एक्सप्रेशन में मैंने अभी कुछ नहीं लिखा, सिर्फ ओमेगा टी के जगह ओमेगा के जगह ओमेगा टी डैश, प्लीज रिमेम्बर इस एक्सप्रेशन में मैं ओमेगा टी डैश लिख रहा है और कुछ नहीं कर रहा है। और यहाँ भी ओमेगा टी डैश की वैल्यू रखते ही ACL जीरो, ACL ओमेगा टी डैश कितना है, यूनिटी, दैट्स द डेफिनेशन आई एम सेइंग। सो दैट इज इक्वल टू वन इज दिस फंक्शन। इफ स्क्वेयर टर्म इज मच लार्जर देन दिस ब्रैकेटेड टर्म इज लार्जर देन वन विच विल बी बिकॉज दिस टर्म इज वी कैन थिंक लाइक देन ACL 0 will be omega t dash upon omega 0 a 0 upon, ये 1 छोड़ दिया, if this term is larger than 1 then I leave 1, square terms को under root किया तो ये का यही रह गया, so I get omega t dash upon omega 0 into a 0 by, is that clear, इसको ऊपर करो फिर term, so you will get this expression. So what is omega t dash now? ACL 0 into omega 0 into A0 by ACL 0. ACL at omega T dash is 1, substitute that equal to omega T dash. Then I say if the condition is such that this term is much larger than 1, then I square and under root goes. Then I say ACL 0 is this, ye isko idhar le jao, so ACL 0 is this. And if I say that omega t dash is omega 0 a 0 by ACL 0 into ACL 0, ACL 0 cancels, which is a 0 into omega 0, which is your omega t. So your omega t dash, so under what condition this was valid? That the omega dash t by omega 0 a 0 ACL 0 is much larger than this, if it is guaranteed, then the omega t dash will be always equal to omega t, is that correct? So our assumption in our figure, and which always normally, because ACLC will always be lower than that, this condition will be always met. So onwards then the gain will fall with the same point 20 dB per decade down to omega t, is that correct? So our, if I have an amplifier, I can now think closed loop karne se aur kuch nahi hoga, उसका ओमेगा टी सेम रहेगा, उसका क्लोज लूप गेन नीचे आ जाएगा, बैंडविड्थ प्रोपोर्शनेटली ए जीरो बाय ए सी एल जीरो से बढ़ जाएगी, इज दैट क्लियर? दैट इज़ व्हाट एसेंशियली फीडबैक एम्पलीफायर्स डू, ओके, इज दैट क्लियर? दिस इज द स्ट्रांगेस्ट पॉइंट ऑफ फीडबैक दैट आई हैव नाउ कंट्रोल ओवर द फॉल ऑफ गेन्स एज पर आई व्हाट आई एम लुकिंग फॉर, इज दैट क्लियर? ये सब किस अजम्पशन पे किया मैंने? डोमिनेंट पोल वो नहीं है तो इसको बहुत कॉम्प्लिकेटेड आता है, नहीं कर सकते ये भी नहीं है, बट पर फीडबैक लगाने से नेचुरली इस पोल स्प्लिट हो जाते हैं, सो डोमिनेंट पोल फीडबैक में करीब करीब गारंटीड है, करीब करीब, ऐसे उन सम केसेस इट डजंट सम अदर डे। सो व्हाट इज द एडवांटेज ऑफ फीडबैक? इट ऑलवेज स्प्लिट्स द पोल्स, ओके, उसका क्या एडवांटेज है? एक डोमिनेंट दिखता है और जैसे ही डोमिनेंट पोल मिला, गेन बैंडविड्थ प्रोडक्ट को आप फिक्स कर सकते हैं, ओके, फिर सकते हैं गेन कम करो, फीडबैक कम, एज सून एज बैंडविड्थ आई इंप्रूव, दैट क्लियर? दिस इज द थ्योरी ऑफ ओपैम फ्रीक्वेंसी रिस्पॉन्स, इज दैट करेक्ट? सो क्लोज लूप गेन आर टू, और वो भी आई ऑल्सो एक्सप्लेन टू यू दैट अंडर वॉट कंडीशंस दिस एक्सप्रेशन, वेर इज दैट, that the gain is valid equal to 1 plus R2 by R1 only and only if the open loop gain is very very large, which all op-amps, why A0 is always very large? The diff-amp followed by gain stage gives very large gains, is that correct? So is that why we are using op-amps? Because this is guaranteed for everything by using an op-amp, is that point clear? This is an essential feature of op-amp circuits. इसलिए ओपन लूप ओपैम को क्या बोलेंगे? डिफैम, बिकॉज इट्स जस्ट अ डिफरेंशियल एम्पलीफायर, ओके, बिकॉज इफ देर इज नो फीडबैक देन इट विल सैचुरेट, बिकॉज एज सून एज सिग्नल वी जीरो एक्सीड्स वी डी डी इट विल सैचुरेट टू वी डी डी और टू नॉन लिनियरिटी विल स्टार्ट बिल्डिंग, एम्पलीफायर विल नॉट रिमेन एम्पलीफायर, इज दैट पॉइंट क्लियर? दिस इज द इम्पॉर्टेंट फैक्टर विच यू ऑल शुड कंसिडर when you work on op-amps. Why op-amps? Why analog people do not want to use single ended amplifiers, okay, or cascade amplifiers, but they want to use op-amps. Is that clear? Op-amp is therefore extraordinarily great device which can do almost everything what you are really looking for. Is that clear? And still M chip, it is controllable, whatever values you want, you can achieve those values very very accurately. Is that clear? We will quit this, but ek introduce karke jayenge. So next time we are going to start this area for which we are waiting, signal conditioning ka pahla part. All these circuits so far shown here, what were there? They were independent functions. Now I say multiple functions can be used, multiplier was multiple functions, but otherwise we will start looking use of now op-amp circuits, okay. First thing we will use them as filters, okay. Is that point clear? These are four kinds of filters we want to use. Just for this, the low pass filter ka cutoff FH bolte hai. Why it is called FH? Because it is the highest frequency up to which gain or transfer function is 1, okay. This is the lowest, below which it is 0, rest is high, okay. If I have a band pass, I have between some frequency F1, F2, our gain is the transfer function is 1, and if in between there is transfer function 0, rest it is 1, then we say it is band reject, okay. Band reject. So we will use this all four. Can you think that actually only 2 should be sufficient to create other 2? इसको यदि मैनिपुलेट किया तो ये दोनों मैनिपुलेट हो जाएंगे. इज दैट करेक्ट? ओवरलैप करो या बाहर करो, तो यू कैन ऑलवेज गेट बैंड पास एंड बैंड रिजेक्ट. सो बेसिक 2 फिल्टर्स कौन से हैं? लो पास और हाई पास. सी यू देन.